Summer outlook, we continue to have a typical summer table mountain profile during summer, and so it is expected during the summer as well, with a peak at around 20 hours, and relatively flat during the day, flat demand during the day. While the system remains tight, we will continue with maintenance with no or limited load shedding. This summer is likely to be hotter than the previous year, with higher expected demand in electricity throughout the day as consumers switch on air conditioners and pool pumps during the summer. We plan to meet demand for electricity 100% of the time and implement stage one load shedding only when demand increases beyond available capacity, which at the moment is not anticipated. The 2 hours, 20 minutes of stage one load shedding that took place on the 14th of September was an extreme incident, as there was a loss of a number of generating units in quick succession. This phenomenon can repeat itself anytime, and we say that it is possible to have a very limited amount of stage one load shedding if things go terribly wrong in the next couple of months. However, no load shedding is anticipated. Key industrial customers experienced stage two load curtailment only once in the last 99 days, on the 9th of October, for 5 hours and 30 minutes. So there has been speculation, especially in the media, that in fact we do not have load shedding because we are doing load curtailment for the large customers. And the last time that happened was on the 9th of October for 5 hours and 30 minutes. The Tetris project has resulted in better predictability. For example, Midubi Unit 6 remained on planned outage for 21 days with no load shedding. We also have, even today, Unit 2 of Quebec still on a planned outage until December. It enables us to perform maintenance within our maintenance budget of about 4,500 megawatts of planned maintenance. And during severe heat, the heat wave experienced in early October, we were able to perform maintenance without load shedding. Eskom has connected an additional 43 independent power producers with a total capacity of 2,147 megawatts, of which 2,021 megawatts is in commercial operation. An additional 334 megawatts from the Department of Energy's DDSA project has also been connected, which is a diesel OCGT, and coal stocks are sustained at a healthy level of 58.2 days on average. There has been reports that the reason we do not have load shedding is as a result of reduced demand because of slow economic growth. But the fact of the matter is that 2014, this is the demand profile, and 2014 is the green line, 2014 is the purple line. And this big brown block, or this line here, represents 2015. The statement is true somewhat, but we only had reduced demand in the weeks 43 to 45, or maybe even 44 to 46, and we see demand picking up again. But generally, the demand profile has been the same, and in fact, we see it increasing. There was another article during the week, last week, saying that the demand profile has remained relatively similar over the August to October period over the last 3 years. But the recent stable supply of electricity, the 99 days, has resulted in an increase in manufacturing output, which rose 0.9% year on year compared to a revised minus 0.3% for August. Factory production also jumped 2.2% and was up 1.4%. And we hope to continue to contribute positively to the South African economy by making making electricity available and allowing manufacturing and factory production, as well as mining production, to be able to continue to function and contribute to the growth of the South African economy.